Right, good afternoon everybody. I was going to make a video today. I don't know why, I'm banned from Facebook, so I can't speak to anybody how I normally would, which is driving me crazy, but in a way it's good because I'm addicted to the bloody thing and I've had enough of it. I wish there was a way we could promote back to the old days when you actually went to the pub and gave a flyer to somebody and we all got together and went out, but you can't because Facebook control us and I keep getting banned constantly, so it's driving me mental. So anyway, I was going to do a video, but I got an email this morning from a lady wanting a refund because her husband had died, which, God, it's horrible when that happens. So I phoned the lady up. Her name's Lorraine Dyer, lives down in Swindon. Then she explained to me how her husband had been suffering for 5 years from cancer, and it got to all his vital organs, and sadly died last week, leaving his kids and grandchildren behind him. But you know, he'd been focusing on coming to the Skinhead reunion. She said he bought a new Arrington. He'd been watching all the videos and the photographs on the page and was so excited about coming. He was focusing on it. And this is not the only one. I've had four or five of these guys over the years that have done it. And they've suffered through cancer and terminal illness and have focused on the Skinhead reunion as a place to come with all the mates, get back together, listen to the music we love and be around our like-minded people. And sadly, you know, many of them have lost their battle along the way. So I feel it's our duty really, in their name, to carry on, you know, for all the highs and lows, all the stress and the grief that this event gives us, well, me, you know. So I'll be honest, so many times I think I just can't take this anymore, the abuse. You know, I made a video the other day about having, like, you know, the virus and, you know, and getting a load of shit for it from various people, you know, thinking I was trying to ego, whatever. But, you know, this virus is on different levels. You know, some people are getting it severely and they're ending up in hospital on life support machines. Other people are just getting a mild cough. Other people a headache. You know, it's all different levels and it is a lot of people. You know, a lot of people. Just been talking to mates in London, the madness lot, and the other mates, and they're all saying this friend's got it, that friend's got it, you know. You know, the pyramids, Frank's brother-in-law's got it. You know, lots of people are getting this. So stay inside, stay strong, right? And I want to play this song to Julian, because Julian is in our minds, you know. He's one of us. I don't know Julian, I never met him, but he's an old skinhead. And when I spoke to Lorraine and she told me all what he said drove his kids mad, all about his skinhead stories of growing up in Swindon and the West Country and all that, I know the guy. I know exactly who the guy is because we're all like that. We've all got those stories. I drove my kids mad for years over them, drive people on the internet mad for them. But you know, we've got to keep fighting, we've got to keep strong, and we've got to focus. And we're going to be there in the Skinhead reunion. It might not be in June, so it's going to be in September. If it's not September, you can't make the 11th, 12th and 13th of September, then you know, your tickets can roll on to next year. But we're going to keep strong, we're going to stay powerful, and we're going to make it happen. So I'm going to play this song, and it's called Not Home Today by Madness. And I think the words, it's basically about a guy called Perry Buckland in Camden. And back in the late 70s or early, yes, about 79 I think it was, they got up to Ali Pali, I think it was, and someone got stabbed. And Perry was a bit of a tough guy, and he'd been, you know, he was a bit of a name around the town, and his name got put forward for it. Now, whether he was guilty or not, we don't know, but there was a big campaign at the time, you know, Perry Buckland is innocent, and it was the same as, you know, George, what was the other one? George Davis is innocent, which was another one that was all around London. George Davis was a blagger. Perry, one of the lads, you know, bit of a tough guy. Apparently he'd been boasting a bit that he was there, but no one really knows. But there was a campaign, and he got banged up for life for it. I'm not sure what happened to him. The rumour was, and it is only a rumour because I don't know, I can't verify this, I've rung up a few people this morning, apparently he committed suicide years later, but I don't know if that's true, so I don't want to say that as fact. But, you know, just a lesson for all of us as teenage kids. We all knew that story around London at the time. And it was just one of them things. And kids, even now today, are still stabbing each other. We've got all this stuff going on around London. You know, kids stabbing each other all the time. You know, last year, Neville Staples' nephew lost his life that way. So it's not changed. That's 40 years ago. So anyway, enough of my waffle. I'll play the tune. And there we have it, Not Home Today by Madness. And I've got to say that of all the bands that have come over the last 40 years that I've been in this scene, there's no one better than Madness. I mean, they started off on a council estate in Camden Town. They're very good friends of mine. And they've gone from a council estate to singing on top of Buckingham Palace. And the skinhead scene, you know, quite a lot of the UK scene, they all sort of like, you know, brush them off as pop stars and that. But I'll tell you what, they're as genuine now as they were then. I rung Chrissy Boy up just literally an hour ago about Julian dying, and you know, and his first thought was, you know, oh, shall I send him a signed picture? That's a bit tacky, a bit crap. We'll think of something, you know. And you know, and this is, you know, straight away, there is no second thought. And that is why I love that band as well. You know, I said about Coxbury yesterday, Madness, best guys in the world, the most successful band to ever come out of the skinhead scene, bar none. All right, and they are still gigging, still playing, still amazing. Chrissy just invited me for a bike ride a minute ago down the seafront. Well, not a minute ago, when, you know, we'll have it once this plague's over. But, you know, keep it together, chaps and chapesses, because you never know what's around the corner. All right, we'll see you in June. If not, we'll see you in September. And hopefully both or one of those or two of those events will go ahead. And if not, next year. But we will see you in September 11th, 12th and 13th, 2020 for the Great Skinhead Reunion. Take it easy.